Hello, my name is Marshawa, and in this video I will show you how to configure PC-lint Plus to support Visual Studio. PC-lint Plus can be configured to support any C or C++ compiler. This is accomplished by creating a compiler configuration that informs PC-lint Plus of important compiler characteristics, including where to find system headers, the size of fundamental types, and so on. Generating a compiler configuration is the first step in utilizing PC-lint Plus. So let's get started. We will start off by locating the installation files of PC-lint Plus. Within the PC-lint Plus distribution, we should be able to find the executable pclpvsconfig.exe under the config folder. This executable helps us generate the compiler configuration for Visual Studio projects. Keep in mind, if you still need to download PC-lint Plus, you can watch the first 2 minutes of the video linked down in the description. Running the executable successfully depends on 3 steps. The first is installing Python. There are plenty of tutorials that cover that topic, but we will leave an additional link down in the description. The second is installing the modules regex and pyaml, and we can do that by opening a shell. Simply click on the Python window and type in cmd. Once the shell window is open, we can go ahead and type in the command pip install regex, click enter. Once the installation is complete, we can run the second command, which is pip install pyaml. And now that the modules are installed successfully, we can go ahead and close the command window. And the third step is to make sure that pclpconfig.py, compilers.yaml, and imposter are all placed in the same directory. And now we will launch the executable pclpvsconfig.exe. I'm going to check the 64-bit box since the project that I'm building targets 64 bits. I'm going to double click on Visual Studio 2022. The executable now asks you to choose Visual Studio solution or project. Once you have located the Visual Studio solution, in my case, I have a sample project here, you can go ahead and click open. The second step is to select where you would like the PC-lint Plus compiler configuration file to be saved. In this case, I'm going to save it under that same directory under the name co_vs2022_x64.lnt. And click save. The third step is asking to name the project configuration and the location of where you want it to be placed. Again, I'm going to leave it in the same directory as before and click save. And the fourth step is asking where to save the bat file that's going to be resulting from the executable running. And I'm going to save it in the same directory. I'm going to click save again. And now this step is asking for where pclp_config.py, imposter, and compilers.yaml are located. As we've seen previously, they were all located under the config folder. So I'm going to go ahead and click on pclp_config.py and click open. Please take a moment to read this following warning before continuing. You can pause the video if you need to. Once you have read the warning and you're ready to proceed, go ahead and click yes. The following message indicates that the executable ran successfully, so we can go ahead and click OK. And now we can open the folder where we saved the generated .bat file. Note that if you need to edit the command for any reason or take a look at it before running it, you can open the generated .bat file with a text editor. If you are ready to run the .bat file, you can go ahead and double click it. Once you run the .bat file, you'll see a shell window pop up briefly, and then the following files generated, the .lnt, .h, and then the project configuration. Here's what the project configuration looks like, including a few directories that are needed, and referencing the project module for analysis, which is sample.cpp. And here's the generated compiler configuration. These are some of the options that are needed by Visual Studio. Note that I created the compiler configurations for C++ 20, so if you wanted to use an earlier version, you can open up the .bat file with the text editor and change the C++ version that you want to use. In addition to that, it's important to make sure that the size options and the include directories were generated correctly. I hope you have found this video to be helpful. To go further, feel free to check out the video link down in the description where we go over integrating PC-lint Plus with Visual Studio. If you run into any issues or if you have video topic suggestions, feel free to chat to us on support@pclintplus.com. Have a good one.